I'm staff writer Lex Friedman, and I'm going to show you how to identify and deal with apps that are slowing down your Mac. Sometimes, our Macs behave badly. If your Mac is grinding to a halt, occasionally a single misbehaving app is responsible, but it's not always obvious which app that is. The good news is, you can turn to another application that came free with your Mac for help, one that lets you quickly identify and severely punish the misbehaving app in question. Go to your Applications folder and find the Utilities folder inside it. Here, I typed the letter U in the Applications window to jump right to the Utilities folder I was after. Inside the Utilities folder sits Activity Monitor. Double-click it to launch it, as you would any other app. Activity Monitor shows all the apps and processes that are currently running on your Mac. When trouble's afoot, you generally want to find out which app is dominating your Mac's processors. To do that, you want to sort Activity Monitor by the %CPU column. So click on it. You might have to click on it a second time to ensure that processes using the most CPU are sorted to the top. Now, things hop around a bit in Activity Monitor, and that's normal. Different apps and processes are always running on your Mac, and sometimes we'll need to use a bit of extra CPU processing power, so don't worry about that. What we're looking for is an app that's misbehaving, one that's gobbling up more than its fair share of CPU and for too long a time. This isn't an exact science. But if my Mac is going too slow when I see, say, iTunes or some background calendar process is up there gobbling 90% or more of my CPU, I'll gladly shut the app down to see if that improves things in a hurry. To quit a process, click on it, and then click the Quit Process button. Then you choose whether to quit or force quit it. Force quitting is riskier if it's an app that has unsaved changes, like, say, a Word document, because you'll lose those. But most of the time, I choose force quit anyway. It ensures the process will get terminated immediately, and it's more viscerally satisfying, too. Now, one more important tip about Activity Monitor. Its dock icon can be extremely useful. Sure, the default chart looks lovely, but you can turn the dock icon into a live updating chart that shows precisely what's going on behind the scenes on your Mac in real time. Control-click, two-finger-click, or right-click on the icon, and choose an option from the dock icon submenu. I like the Show CPU Usage option. If that bar fills up too much, say beyond halfway, I know something troubling may be unduly burdening my Mac's processors, and I can click to see if there's a process or two that I ought to force quit with extreme prejudice. So that's Activity Monitor. If your Mac isn't running right and you're not ready to reboot the whole enchilada, it's worth a look. Thanks for watching.